Well, hello and welcome to Jimonism Total Nerdery channel, and my templates are ongoing, but before I release the templates and stuff and finish them up, we'll be releasing a little... It will basically be like a little... What to say? Teaser? Or... anyways, it will be an additional package to the template. This is the Civil Doc. I made this little set to be, you know... a civil type of doc, which is supposed to be easy to set up. It will have public permission. It will also be designed to be in non-gravity, and it will not feature airlocks but simple openings, so that this will be basically the first doc you meet, so you can travel and float in space to it if you wish. And necessarily not use gravity. So I'll show you how it looks like. It's I call it GHIC doc. Now there are lots of things here because I failed with name saving or changed the name, so I will remove those. But so basically, say we want to create a new doc here. We have a hub here, the hub part. You can imagine you can put the hub part in like an entrance area or connect it directly up to a real airlock or something like that. But then there is the tube part. The tube part is really, you know, to prolong the dock in, whoops, don't place it like that, in different directions. You might want to have it a bit away, like this maybe. And say we also want to have a little dock here too. And just one going on there. I'll just build you a little dock here to show you what we can do. So we'll have another hub here. Oops, like that. Nice hub. Then there is the fantastic little window, which I need to show you right now. Here you can see we have a window. Place it there. It's looking real cool. It's designed to align up with everything you might put it to. So, you see, this is a just one of those. You can put a window here, and it will fit up snugly to the end of tubes as well. As well as, of course, these regular, where you can put windows easily. You have to remove the red light. I use red lights to make sure that the copy and paste box is perfect. So, what more? There is the auto USD. The auto USD is a pretty neat solution, like this. I'll show you how it works, but I can tell you how it works as well, if you're in a hurry or whatever. But basically, when you dock here, now when you turn these around, you have to manually place the rail correctly afterwards. That's nothing I can do about it. I'm sorry about that, but that's just how the templates work right now. Anyways, when you dock, the door will open automatically and the color scheme will change to busy. So that's how they work. Then there is also the vertical tube. The vertical tube is not working as flawless as the other stuff, because if you use the vertical tube, you will not be able to have gravity. So with vertical tubes, gravity is a no-go, basically. But I'll show you, I spawn some vertical tubes here, whoops, just put them where they should be. Now let's see here. No, there of course, yes. When you spawn the vertical tube, you need to make an opening. You need to take out blocks in a 3x3 pattern. To use the vertical tubes, you can either install a stairway or something like that, but they're actually designed to be used with like no gravity. And you can see here they align up here, and I put this here so the ring doesn't look weird. So you basically can go here and you can go down the vertical tube and you can connect it to another tube or another hub is the plan. And on the other hub you can have more docks if you wish. I guess you could put a dock directly onto that, but it doesn't look as cool because the docks are designed to be put on directly on a hub or directly on a tube ending, regular tube. Anyways, it's the same here. If there is in the top, you'll just need to take it out here. And there is a little ring here to make it look better when you do it like that. So, well, that's nice. Let's paste the hub here. And this is what's not super flawless. You just have to have a little block here so you can put the hub down nicely. Like that. Just take out this little area and we'll have a new world. And when we have these docks here, let's see here, out dock, okay. You can see we can place the out dock directly onto the hub as well, and it will look like this. If I get out of this, I can show you how it is to dock a thing here. Let's have something with USD. Something small and fast. We'll definitely, oh yeah, we'll go for the Skyjumper. Like that. And where is the Skyjumper? Over there. And we'll totally jump into that one. We'll activate the wings right away. Whoops, wait, where am I? Problematic. Okay, so I don't know if we need to reset this, but just go to the dock and, well, no, too far away. And you'll just dock here. Then you can see the green light is off and the red light is now on. When we go here, wrong. You can see the door is automatically opened and it's public permission module. So it's, you know, everyone can dock and you can have your guests and people like that. And well, yeah, you know, that's basically the purpose of the public dock set. Or I call it the civil dock, thus sea dock. And you see, they look pretty neatly. They work without and with gravity. If you use with gravity, then the vertical tubes will be harder to maneuver, as you might understand. But, well, you could basically, you know, I'll just show you. You'll need a public permission module so that everyone can use gravity, but you basically have gravity, you know, in places where you need it. Yeah, you'll get the point. Just install some gravity there and you can toggle in and off of gravity. And oh yeah, this is the closed gate from the inside, but you know, when there is no ship docked, these are closed and they can't be opened if you're not owner, but you know, and that's basically an airlock in a way. But well, there you have it, the sea dock. It will be up onto the StarMaid dock, so I hope you find it there if you're interested, and well, I'll hope you enjoy it, and I'll be catching you next time, GeoMedism Total Nerd Channel, signing out.